You guys wonder where we were? Thank you for coming live. What are you guys doing? I have to say, this is our sixth Facebook Live in my living room, wine and music session. And thank you for joining every week. This is amazing. And you make my week every week. You give me a reason to put on makeup, not to put on shoes, but just to have some fun, drink some wine, and it gives me a chance to kind of practice some songs with my husband over the week, which has been totally fun. Thank you for coming here. It just makes me feel more connected, and I'm watching the changes in the news and the changes in the country. Some of our friends are going back to work, which is amazing. But right now, I know that our gigs are, you know, kind of going from right now to either next year at this time or in the fall. So stick with me, and we'll let you know our tour schedule and, you know, what's going on. So, you know, as things progress, we'll let you know. But it all depends on how healthy everyone is, and we just want you to be safe. So it's all about that. Now, I've got some music for you. I've had so much fun coming up with music. We're smoking ribs out in the back right now. See, this is one of the beauty, you know, one of the beautiful things about shelter in place. We cook more. So Eric is smoking ribs out there, and they smell so good, so it made me think of a perfect song. And this song was off my Wild Heart CD. I wrote it with my friend Dave Yaden, and we had so much fun writing this song, and we had even more fun recording it, and we've played it live for just years and years and years. So, this song is called Hot Sauce. Gotta test it out. To I kind of go through my back catalog, go through the records that we've just done, and pull out songs that I think are cool, and pull out songs that you think are cool that we haven't played for a while. So I wish I had my band, but you get the ambiance of my living room, and you get wine, and you get no microphones. You get au naturel. So I love it. We need to do more of this. So I wanted to do this next song, and this is not something I've really played live with my band, but this is something that at the very beginning of my career, I sat in for my friend Terry Harrington for a couple months, and he is the sax player who is the sax player for The Simpsons. And he's Lisa Simpson, and he's Bleeding Gums Murphy, and he's just, he's a great guy, just an amazing guy. So I sat in for him playing jazz standards while he got a heart transplant and had to come back and get strong. So what a cool thing, and he's amazing now. And so this is for him. This is called My Romance, and there are parts to being shelter in place that are romantic. So you should, you know, scoot up to the one you love. There are parts that aren't romantic, but scoot up to the one you love for this. My Romance. Here, look at all this. Like the wine is every week, just getting more and more and more and more. but that's good. There's no chance of us running out. So let me introduce you to my husband, Eric Guerra.
I got to make a change.
Okay. Oh!
We're going to put the bar sign on.
Oh, we got to put the bar sign on.
Yeah, where's the bar sign? Is that on?
Oh, yeah.
Woo!
Yeah.
All right.
All right,
now
cheers,
it's official.
Buddy.
Now it's... Wait a minute. Is your glass bigger than mine?
It seems that way.
That's not cool.
Here, you take it.
All right, thanks. Wait, I got a better glass for you. Hold on.
I like this.
This is a real Pinot Noir glass. We got a few people out there that are actually watching the type of glassware we use.
I know, right?
And I want to say thank you for all the help. But, you know, we break a lot of glasses when you drink this much wine, so you got to just use whatever you have. But this is a real Pinot Noir glass. It's got a little flange on the top there, so because Pinot Noir is not very aromatic. So it takes all the aromas, puts them up to the top, and then makes them come out the top like a flower. So what are we drinking today, man?
We are drinking our own wine. Was this our very first?
Yep.
This was our first shipment that we did.
Our first. There's only 7 bottles left in the world.
I know, it's amazing.
Imagine.
This, we were going through photos the other night, and this was our very first shipment, and it was in October last year.
October, November, yeah.
Yeah, and that was
sold
huge
out.
For us. We sold out, and this is just one of my favorite wines because of that. But it's a beautiful wine, Pinot Noir, and we named it Imagine.
So, you know what's coming up? Before we do our wine tasting, you know what's coming up in a couple weeks? Mother's Day.
Mother's Day.
It's going to give you the answer anyway. Mother's Day.
I'm like,
And you know what? I know everybody who's watching right now and who's going to watch, the thousands of people are going to watch later. I know all your mothers. I do. Don't ask why. Okay. But they don't want roses. I mean, you get flowers, whatever. You get flowers for your mother. But get your mother wine is a great idea.
I like that.
So, this isn't too salesy, is it?
Actually, I'd rather have wine than flowers.
Yeah, I think so, right? So so if you go to reservetastings.com, and our daughter Jordan is kind of manning my account right now, you'll see my name come up, so you'll get the URL. But www.reservetastings.com, you go to the wine shop, and we have 2 brand new wines that we were drinking the last couple weeks in there, Soul and Harmony. It's Cabernet and a red blend GSM. And there's a 30% shelter-in-place discount that's still available for these new wines. So anybody out there who's interested in drinking our wine and trying it before you sign up for the official membership, it's reservetastings.com.
I like that.
Great Mother's Day gift.
Yeah. Your mom is probably watching
probably
right now.
She's probably right now.
Hi.
Irene.
So is mine. My mom said she's never drank so much wine in her life as she has in this past month. And guess what? In California, we've got 1 more month to go.
Yep.
Wow.
So. All right, so let's talk about Pinot Noir. So one of the things about Pinot that people don't know is it is one of the most difficult wines to make in the world. Most winemakers are psychologists or psychology majors because the wine goes through all these different iterations. It's a very thin-skinned grape, and it can get funky, it can get fruity, it can go bad, it can be great. And while the winemaker is making it, it goes through all these permutations, I mean, almost on a weekly basis, and even in the bottle. So that's why that when people love Pinot, they love it a lot. Because when you get Pinot right, it could be one of the most fabulous wines in the world and one of the most expensive. So you think Cabernet, Merlot, the big Bordeaux, the California Napa Cabs are the most expensive wines in the world. The most expensive wine in the world, and you've heard me say this 1,000 times, so you know what the answer is.
I'm busy drinking.
Is a Burgundy Pinot Noir-based Domaine de Romanée-Conti. I think it's sold for $15,000 a bottle at this point. So, there's
that
a reason
a
why
Pinot's...
Yeah, well,
it's our anniversary coming up.
Don't give that to your mother. Send that one to us. I'll appreciate it more, right? So, let's do our tasting. Enough of the blah, blah, blah. All right, we'll get on with the tasting, and then we'll get on with the music, right? So, the first thing with Pinot Noir, what's the color going to... Well, what's the first thing that we do in our tastings?
Cheers!
Cheers, everybody out there. Cheers! All right, I'm going to crash that glass. That'll be our last Pinot, though, and I'll get in trouble for not using the right glass again. All right, so, but you look at the color. Now, Pinot Noir is very cherry, usually. Maybe a little bit of earthiness on it. And what I mean by earthiness, this is an unfiltered wine. Doesn't mean it's a bad wine. Just means that the winemaker didn't filter it. So that means that a lot of good stuff is left in. A lot of chewy good stuff. So let's...
Not chewy.
Nah, The legs aren't too pronounced because that indicates alcohol, and Pinot Noirs don't have usually a very high alcohol. They're grown in cooler regions because they're such a thin-skinned, delicate grape. And let's take a smell. I'm going to try to do this. Now, Pinot Noirs have very bright cherry on their nose, and it depends where they come from, Burgundy or Carneros or Napa or Sonoma, Russian River, Mendocino. This one's from Monterey County, so there's a lot of really good red fruit on it. But also, you're probably noticing a little bit of earthiness.
I do.
And Pinots can come across as earthiness like a dry floor of a forest or mushrooms. Like very mushroomy sometimes, but in a good way, I promise you.
I love the earth on it.
Yeah,
it's
definitely.
Cool. Yeah.
And what you smell should carry forward on the palate, usually, most of the time. And sometimes you can find some other flavors like oak.
Careful there.
Did it. And And the texture is outstanding of this wine and hopefully of your Pinot Noir. A good Pinot Noir should have great texture. And texture, like just like the word says, you should be able to feel it on your mouth, be able to feel the weight of it, feel the how beautiful the fruit is and maybe the mushroom or the earthiness. So this is a phenomenal Pinot Noir. Sorry that you guys aren't drinking this one. A bunch of you out there did for Thanksgiving.
You guys might have it still. Yeah. Some of our members have been... Facebook telling me, hey, I got it ready.
We don't have this in the wine shop, but you got the Cabernet and the Harmony GSM that'll be just as good, as I promise you that. All right, so the Imagine label, I'll let Mindy talk a little bit about this, one of my favorite labels, and then we'll get on to playing a little bit more music for you guys.
All right.
Oh, sorry.
Hey, give me the wine.
I'm gonna reiterate. Hey, by the way, is anybody getting really long hair out there?
I know, look at his hair.
Can't go to the...
He's a whole different husband this month than last month.
A hair cutter person? Yeah, I know.
A whole different husband. It's like I'm cheating on my husband.
Isn't that right?
With my husband.
Yes. I'm keeping the glasses on just so I can see.
Okay, I like that. That's better. Okay, so check this out. I made this label, and I just had fun doing it because the Imagine Pinot Noir, this wine is kind of a thinking person's wine. It's not like the winemaker just takes it out. And hey, here's your Pinot Noir. Most of these wines, they're not easy to make. And he's harped on this for years that the guys who are, you know, amazing winemakers for Pinots are, you know, half crazy, half super smart, half mad scientists. And so I've heard these stories
sensitive.
Over the years. Sensitive? Okay, sensitive. So I thought that the playlist and the art for this wine, it had to be the thinking man's game. It had to be meaningful. It had to be kind of, you know, what would you imagine this wine would become when you pick this grape, and what would you imagine it to become? Because it's not a gimme like some other kinds of wine.
Doesn't taste anything like Pinot Noir when you first put it in the barrel when it's new. So you have to imagine what it's going to be like in the future. Yep, so it's the perfect name.
So I made this brush stroke that you can see, and it kind of goes off into Never Never Land. So this could go anywhere. And this is art for the thought that, where will it go? Imagine what it could become. And you can do that with music, you can do that with wine, you can do that with art, but this brushstroke just kind of says that to me. And the playlist for it is the same thing. It's anything from John Lennon to Oasis to, you know, songs that make you think about the world and maybe what things could become. Maybe if we were better to each other, what would the world be? Yeah, just stuff like that.
Yeah.
So I love this wine, and obviously it has a special place in my heart because it was one of our first. And we've come a long way since then.
Oh, yeah. A lot of people have stuck with us, and thank you.
Thank you for ordering our wine and following us and just having fun with us with the music and wine. It's so much fun for us, so we figured it would be fun for you too, but it's extra fun to share it with you. So, all right, so this song, I'm gonna play you a song off our Imagine playlist that you can find on Spotify. And well, this is just a classic, but it goes with the idea of the wine. Imagine what it could be. Imagine what life could be.
I like how I just kind of play the background.
I like this. Can you do this every day?
Hey,
just kinda, you know.
You ready?
I'm ready.
Okay.
Okay.
couldn't see him.
Oh, no!
I was like this. I was peeking around.
And he pulled out his guitar because he just hadn't played it that much since college. And it's kind of been fun. So we've had our little campfire sessions playing guitar. So I decided to pimp him out for these. And you guys have seen him every week playing something.
Sorry.
Hey!
Got it, right? Pulling a china shop. I think the quieter I play, the better we sound, though.
No, I said that one week because I was singing and it was, you know, super low. So.
All right, you ready for the next one?
Yeah, who's here? Do we have a... Do we have a report?
Hold
who's
the,
coming?
Hold up a little sign there. We got Kansas City, Connecticut, Delaware, Ohio, Florida.
Ohio.
Serbia.
Serbia in the house.
Canada, Montana, and the great state of Maryland.
I see Georgia.
And I see Israel, too. So, any Italians in the house?
Right there.
No. I mean, real Italians.
You're holding up the flag for the Italians.
Thanks, Jordan.
Thank you, Jordan. And I know you guys in Florida, you're like going to the beach and doing all this crazy stuff. Don't get sick. Get a tan. Get a tan for me, for goodness sakes.
All right. I'm ready.
All right. So this next song, this is kind of fun. This next song is a song that we recorded on our latest record, Mindi, Abair, and the Bone Shakers, No Good Deed. And Sirius XM Bluesville has been rocking this song. Totally rocking this song. So thank you to Sirius XM Bluesville. This is a cover of a Melody Gardot song, and I was just such a fan of it. But with what we're going through right now, this song has incredible meaning. It's called Bad News. But the bad news is that it's closing time. So this song talks about how the bad news has arrived. It's closing time. The world has closed up over the last month. And it talks about, you know, hide your sons and daughters from the headlines and the news. It's unbelievable. So anyway, this is from our latest record, No Good Deed. And I hope you like it. Bad news.
Ready?
Yeah. That is not the way this song goes.
No?
No.
Whoops.
It's the t-shirt, isn't it?
I don't know. That's the way I'm just...
No.
I'm not a guitarist. I'm very rigid.
No, it's not that. I know what you need.
What?
Ooh. Take a sip of that.
Truth serum.
I think you're gonna know exactly what to do with this song, right?
Feel a little more loosened up.
Yeah, you feel. Yeah, it does that.
All right, how about this?
Okay. Works every time.
There's the dotted line.
That sip helped.
Woo! I'm going to give you more wine. Bad news, baby. It's closing time.
Nice job, wifey.
Thanks,
but
honey.
My time has expired.
You may contain alcohol.
Yeah.
All right, give it up for my husband, Eric Guerra.
Do my best.
You can take the big glass.
I do my best to represent the family as best I can.
Make you play guitar every week. It's so fun. All right, so I just want to thank you for coming in every week. It doesn't go without saying that this is a crazy time, and it just means the world to see you guys, to talk to you, to see your comments, and just feel connected with you guys. You know, it just means the world. So I miss you so much. I miss our concerts, you know, so it's gonna come back, and the world will come back. And when it does, we will be there together. But for now, we have made all of this together, and we have each other, and that's amazing. So I hosted something this week for the city of Los Angeles. It was the Mayor's Fund LA, and all these people, you know, did performances and you know, appeared for us. One of them, well, Smokey Robinson, just such cool people, and Wadi Wachtel, and the band Venice, and Carole King. Carole King came in live from her living room and rewrote her song, Far Away. And she did it with the pandemic in mind, and I just thought that was amazing. She has been just a role model for me musically, and I've always been such a fan of what she does. I got to play with her for her Person of the Year for Music Cares 1 year, paying tribute to her. And so I wanted to do one of her songs, and one of my favorites, they're all my favorites from her. So this is for you guys. And if you ever need me, you got a friend. Okay, move this back. Brighten up, oh, even. in living room. What do you got there? You're my in living room, you know.
Woo! I'm not supposed to come back during this, but there's been a lot of people asking about the ribs. So a lot of people, hickory wood we put on them. This is really inappropriate after a Carole King song, but okay. And there's the ribs. Perfect, what is it, about 9 hour smoke job right there. So, oh yeah, these go good.
Okay, yeah. I love him, but I love him more when he makes ribs. Stop it.
Bye.
I hope you guys are having a great time, and thank you for coming into my living room, our living room, as always. We just have so much fun sharing wine with you. This is our little cocktail hour with you guys, and I want to do it every night, but every Tuesday is all right with me. So we'll see you back here next Tuesday. I've got one more song for you, and I gotta put down the wine, don't I? Maybe I don't. Maybe I can play saxophone and drink wine at the same time, but I'll have to practice that for next week.
Let me get the camera. Okay, got the camera.
Okay, so I've chose a different artist that inspire me and done some of my music as well. So I'm kind of mixing it up as the weeks go by. But this particular song is by an artist that is one of my favorites, and I think he's one of your favorites too. And when I first started playing, when I got my first gigs in college, this was an artist that I had to learn like 20 of his songs for my first show with this band that I was playing with. And it was in Boston, and I just remember I was so happy because it was an artist I loved. So I used to play along to his harmonica playing and his vocals to learn how to phrase a saxophone. So this is one of my biggest influences, Stevie Wonder. And don't get superstitious during all this. Just do what you're supposed to do, be safe, and hopefully we can all be on the other side of this soon. This is for you guys. Superstition. You can get your own groove.
Thank you. Well, all the neighbors, thank you guys for joining us outside of our living room. And I hope you guys have just a great week. We love you so much. And thanks for spending Tuesday nights with us. And I'll see you next week.
All right, Wine Club member Cheryl, you want to say goodbye to everybody?
Bye, everyone.
Woo!